BeCozi.net is here. Today I would like to show you how to make this dog bed. So this is the dog bed that we will be making today. It will be hand crocheting, and we will be using our velvet yarn. This velvet yarn is very thick. It's about over 1 inch thick, and we will be using two colors. We will be using ivory for the base of the dog bed, and we will be using beautiful pale yellow for the walls. So again, this will be the dog bed that we will be making. You can see that the base is ivory and the walls are yellow. And the dog bed is pretty sturdy, unlike any other yarn that we were using for making dog beds or cat's beds. So this will be pretty sturdy. And the good part about this yarn, a dog bed, that it can be easily washed. You can throw it in the washer and in a dryer too to dry after that. So you will need 2 pounds of ivory and 1 pound of yellow to make this dog bed. We have 11 colors of velvet yarn available, and two of them you can see, ivory and yellow. And you can find the velvet yarn at our website, BeCozi.net. And if you're ready, we can get started. Okay guys, so we will be using this ivory color for the base and this beautiful yellow, pale yellow color for the walls. So let's start with the base first. So we're placing the yarn in front, and this is the tail, this is working yarn, and we're making a loop like that. Insert your hand, grab working yarn, and pull it out. This is our first stitch, guys, and we are now gonna do a chain of 7 skeins. So for the chain, we're inserting our hand inside, grab working yarn, and pull it out like this. So we have 2 stitches now, and we're doing the same. The left hand usually holding the stitch like that. This way it will not be unraveling and make it will not get better or smaller. And then you insert in your hand, grab working yarn, and pull it out. Try to make all the stitches about the same size. They're approximately 2 inch each, okay? So here we are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 7 stitches. What we are doing now? We will be hand crocheting around this cast on chain. So this is our first stitch. We insert our hand inside, and then we will be using this top part of the stitches. So this is our stitch that we're not touching, because this is where the stitch is coming from. We are going to undo this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stitches. So here we are inserting our hand in this part of the stitch, grabbing working yarn, and pull it out. You now have 2, and now grab working yarn and pull it through 2. Keep your hand inside the stitch, and now we will be using 2nd stitch over here, not this one, this one. And we insert our hand, grab working yarn, pull it out. Now you have 2 stitches, grab working yarn, and pull it through 2. Keep your hand inside the stitch and do the same with the next one. And now we have 2 more. We are doing the same with this 2 stitches. So this way you can see that we just head crocheted one side on the cast on chain. Now we are switching to another side like that, turn the chain, and you keep the your hand inside the stitch, and now we will be using top part of the stitches. See, you can see them pretty well. So insert your hand, crab walking yarn, pull it out, insert your hand, crab walking yarn, pull it through two. And the same with the next stitch, this called single crochet stitch, and we are doing single crochet stitch around our cast on chain. So here we are, we hand crocheted our first row around the chain. Now we're turning it again and we are crocheting around on this side again. So see this top of the stitches, that's what we will be using, six of them. Insert your hand, grab walking yarn, pull it out, and then pull it through two. This will be our second row, and when we reach the side of this row, we will need to add one stitch on the side. So here we are, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is our number 7. And here we will need to add one stitch. So to avoid this huge hole, I will take one stitch on the bottom and then insert my hand inside this two, the top part and the bottom stitch, and take one stitch out, make a single crochet, and then do the same in the same hole, in the same opening. This way you just added two stitches, see, one extra stitch on the side, and it will make this beautiful round around the side. So now keep doing the same single crochet in every stitch until you reach another side. Spread it a little bit like this, and now on this side we will add one more extra stitch too. Again, if we use this top part, it will be like this big opening. In order to avoid it, you need to use one of the stitches on the bottom. So insert your hand, grab walking yarn, pull it out, and then we will do the same and the same stitch. See, we just made this beautiful round side on the one of the sides. So what we are doing next, guys, we will be doing the same single crochet stitch all the way around until we have the size of the base enough for a small to medium size dog. So here you see we have two stitches here and we need to make three of those. So we're increasing one stitch in every row. So we made one single crochet, now we're going inside the same stitch and we're making one extra. And after that we're going in this next stitch and just keep going around making single crochet stitches until we get to the next side. So now when the side of the bed is becoming bigger, you will need to start adding two stitches on this side, on each side. So we have two stitches here, so we'll go twice in every stitch, one and two. So remember, two rows, two first rows, we added just one stitch on the side, and this row number three, we are adding two stitches by making single crochet inside the same two stitches. See, we have this beautiful round side, and we will keep working around until we reach the next side. Here we are, we have two stitches and we need to make four stitches from this two. So we're going in this stitch twice, once and twice, and then we do the same in the next one, once and twice. Here we are. See, this is our beautiful rounding the side. And now we're going through all the stitches, just one single crochet. Okay, so now we will need to add a few more stitches over here, and we will be adding starting with this stitch. So we were adding 4, now we will be adding 6. So we will be going in every stitch of the 3 twice. So it will be 1, 2, and then in the next one, 1 and 2. And then this stitch over here, 1 and 2. What are we doing here? We are rounding our bed, and this way we're adding stitches, and this way it will not be circling like that when you're making it. Now going in the same top stitches with just a single crochet. The size of the bed you will need to decide for yourself. It depends how big your dog is. This bed, as I mentioned, will be for medium size dog up to 25 pounds. My dog is about 22 pounds, so this will be a perfect size for him. So anyway, 3 stitches on the side, and we will make 6 from those. So going twice in every stitch, 1 and 2, and one more, 1, and let's turn in, and 2. There you go. So here we are. You can spread it nicely. Now let's add one more row on this side. Here we are, guys. So you can count how many rows you made by this is the middle part, and this knots showing you how many rows you made. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We made 5 rows on each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And it's this way it's even. And now we can add the walls for this bed. In order to add walls, let's add one more stitch here that it will be round. This will be the front part of the bed, and here we are now we'll be adding another color. So adding color with velvet yarn can be different. You can either sew it together if you want it to be really, really neat and nice. If you wanted to make it fast and easy, we'll just take some of the feeling from inside like that, from both sides, and now like this. And now we will just make a simple knot with this yarn. And because it will be inside of the pattern, inside of the bed, you will not really see it. So we will cut the yarn close to the knot, and then we will start making the wool. If you are making the blanket with this yarn, it's better to sew it together. See, like here, it's so very nicely, was sewed very nicely, you cannot really see it. So now, in order to make a wool, we will not be using the top part of the stitch, we will be using the whole stitch. You see, the stitch consists of 2 parts, top and bottom. So we will be lifting 2 sides of the stitch and then inserting our hand inside and pulling yarn out. So let's try to keep that knot inside like that.
See, now we have two stitches of different colors, and now we're pulling yarn through those two stitches. Now take this next stitch, both sides, insert your hand, grab working yarn, and pull it out. And now we're doing it through every stitch, pulling both, pushing your hand through the both part of the stitch, not just the top part, like that. And now you can see that this way our wool started forming, and now we will be just going through all stitches on the back side of the bed, like this. This will be our first row for the bed. And if you want to have the wool all the way around, that's fine too, but I'm showing you the bed made with the opening up front that make it easier for a dog to come in into the bed. So we keep doing it around until it will be on the same level as we started. So here we are, see this bed. So see, this is where we started, so this is where we will finish this side of the wool. So you can spread it a little bit like that, and now we're turning on another side, and we will keep crocheting, only we will be going back over here. So insert your hand inside this last stitch, and again we will be using both sides of the stitch. So this is the stitch where this coming from, so we're taking the next one, going underneath, grab working yarn, pull it out, then pull it through two stitches. Next stitch, underneath, grab working yarn, and pull it through. See what we have here? We have a beautiful wool forming, and here we are just going around, forming a beautiful wool for the dog bed. Here's our last stitch, or the first stitch where we started. So we need to go inside the stitch. It was white or ivory. So we're making our last stitch inside. And here we are. We actually pretty much done. So this is our dog bed, almost finished. So if you want to go another row for the higher wool, you definitely can do it. I will keep it this way, and then we will cut the yarn, and the tail will go inside this last stitch like that. Now let's take some filling out, and then we can just tuck in this tail inside any stitches, hide it in, weave it in, and hide it that it wouldn't be noticeable. And the good part, the good feature of velvet yarn, it can be washed, guys. So if merino wool needs to be dry cleaned, and cat bed or dog bed made with merino wool is pretty fragile, this guy will be very sturdy and nice. See, this is how our wool look from the back. And here is our tail that we need to hide where we started. Again, we're taking out the filling, and then we're going underneath any stitch and hide it nicely, or weave in. Here we are. So this is the back or bottom of our dog bed, and this is the top. So now when you have it ready, you can spread it nicely and call your dog to try it on. So you can find this velvet yarn. We have 11 colors. One is out of stock, but it's coming soon. Otherwise, we have 11 colors available, and you can try them on for any projects, including this beautiful dog bed. Stay warm and be cozy.